Great, let's go ahead and bring up our next speaker, Dr. Serena Huang. She is the Global Head of People Analytics at PayPal. Today, she's going to talk to us about people analytics, going from data to action. Dr. Serena Huang is a Global Data Analytics Executive in FinTech and an international keynote speaker on digital transformation, people and analytics, HR technology, future of work, and employee experience. She is currently the Global Head of People Analytics, Visualization, and HR Technology at PayPal. She brings 10 years of post-PhD experience with deep expertise spanning large multinationals, including GE, Kraft Heinz, and Deloitte. As a data analytics executive, Dr. Huang is passionate about leading change, building high-performing global teams, and helping business leaders see data as an asset. She excels at showing executives the art of the possible through both one-on-one dialogues and facilitated hands-on workshops, and co-creating customizable, scalable solutions in predictive analytics in HR, workplace strategy, supply chain, and litigation domains. Welcome to the stage, Dr. Serena Huang. All right, thank you so much for first being patient with that giveaway glitch. Welcome to the DATAcated conference. I will hop off the virtual stage and let you take this away. Really, really looking forward to your talk.
Thank you so much, Kate, for having me. Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Serena Huang, and I lead Global People Analytics and HR Tech at PayPal. Did you see the movie Don't Look Up? Two scientists found evidence that a planet-killing comet was headed straight towards Earth. They were scrambling to get politicians to act, for the public to believe them. No one wanted to take action on science and data. Does that sound familiar? Earlier in my career, that seemed to happen quite often, except I was not predicting anything hitting the Earth. Instead, I was bringing data and forecasts about the most important asset for an organization, people. I remember feeling puzzled by why executives would not act on data that I would bring them. This is sometimes described as the last mile problem in data analytics, getting stakeholders to act on data. Now, many years later, as a data analytics executive, I have perfected the art of getting my stakeholders to act on data. And today I'm here to share with you the simple three-step process to go from data to action. Step one, identify a business problem worth solving. And step two, tell a compelling story with data analysis. Step three, demonstrate business impact continuously. Let's go to the talent and people space. I will walk you through the three-step process using an example. Step one, identify a business problem worth solving. In the era of the great resignation, employee retention is on every leader's mind. If you have identified this as a problem that's keeping your leaders up at night, you might have found a problem worth solving. I tell my team, when it comes to analytics, don't start with data. You have to start with a business problem. How do you do that in practice? It's about actively listening and asking the right questions. There's a lot of art in asking the right questions up front to make sure you're solving the right business problems that will have impact. What data analytics team get a lot from executives is requests for data. A lot of times, analysts would jump in. They will provide the data exactly as requested. What is the problem with that? Well, pausing and asking simple questions like, what are you planning to do with this data? And what is the business metric that you're trying to improve with this data can go a long way. If you get a seemingly simple request, like how many employees left our organization last month? Or what is our historic customer retention rate? You might think the business problem is really simple and straightforward. In my experience though, you may be missing context if you don't pause and ask simple questions to confirm. So next time, before you pull any data or work on any analysis, ask yourself this question. Are you working on something that's keeping your leaders up at night? So that's step one. The second step to take you from data to action is to tell a compelling story with data analysis for the audience. Have you sat through a presentation that goes something like this from a data analytics professional? We gather this data, we spent a gazillion hours cleaning it. We did this fancy analysis, it has some findings. Some are really interesting, some were not so interesting. The end. What is the problem with this flow? Well, it leaves the executives in the room wondering what they're supposed to do with that information. A good data storyteller leaves no storytelling to chance. Let me repeat that. A good data storyteller leaves no storytelling to chance. You will know the recommendations, the next steps, and how data supports those recommendations from a good storyteller. Now, storytelling generally has three components: data, visualization, and the story or narrative. You need all three to come together. So let's go back to the employee attrition analysis. You have confirmed in step one, this is a business problem worth solving for. You dig into the data a bit and you found a really interesting nugget that new hires outside of your HQ location are resigning at a higher rate, and that trend is increasing. Yet new hires at the HQ location are staying flat in terms of the attrition rate. You dig a little bit deeper and you looked at their feedback from new hire surveys. You have found a sharp contrast between the HQ location and a non-HQ location in terms of a sense of feeling connected to colleagues. You check a little bit further and you confirm with the exit interview survey data for those who actually left that new hires cite lacking a sense of connection to the organization as why they were leaving. So now you have done your data analysis. How do you put everything together? So let's go back to the three elements: data, visualization, and story. Data, you have your new hire attrition rate, you have your survey feedback from employees, and the contrast between HQ and non-HQ. What visualization would you put together? Maybe two graphs, one showing the new hire attrition at HQ trending upwards compared to those outside. Now, the second graph, you might show the survey results comparing again the HQ and non-HQ locations. Maybe you throw in a keywords analysis from the comments showing a sense of connection being important. So you have done your data analysis at this point, you have some visualization. How do you put it all together with story or narrative? Now, the story or narrative, this is your headline if you're writing the news. A good story should have three C's, I would suggest that you follow: clear, care, and call to action. The message should be clear. Your audience should care. And there should be a very clear call to action. So some story for this analysis, for example, could be: new hires outside the HQ fail to feel connected and resigned at 1.5 times the rate as those at the HQ. Leaders must quickly build a sense of community and connection to retain new hires. This is what I mean when I said a good storyteller leaves no storytelling to chance. The message is clear, your audience cares, and there's a very clear call to action. So that's step two. The third and the final step is to demonstrate business impact. Whether that's customer retention or employee retention, there are quantifiable business impact that you can share. Let's go back to your employee attrition example. Once you have made the recommendation to reduce the retention, reduce the attrition for new hires outside the HQ, do you know how many people your organization hires outside of HQ? What is the cost of turnover for employees? And what is the potential cost savings if your organization were to reduce the attrition rate? Those could be additional call to action items to add to your story. The dollar impact is usually very compelling for your executives. That's really important piece of information to include. Now, demonstrating business impact is never a one-time effort. You want to do this continuously. Once you make the recommendation, 6 months later, Is the attrition rate for new hires outside the HQ actually going down? By how much? Are you really on track to save the organization as much as you claim that you would? 12 months later, rinse and repeat, check again. You get the idea. If you're able to show business impact continuously, you will never hear from leaders that you are working for a data analytics team that does not speak the business language. That's step three. To recap, to go from data to action, the simple three-step process you want to follow: one, identify a business problem worth solving. Two, tell a compelling story with data analysis. Three, continuously demonstrate business impact. Thank you so much for your time today. You can follow me on LinkedIn for regular updates or subscribe to my monthly newsletter, which you've guessed it, it's called From Data to Action.
I love it. Thank you so much for your presentation. And we'll put a link to your website, From Data to Action, into the comments so it makes it easier for people to go ahead and sign up. We have several questions that came in. I'm going to go ahead and start here with, there was a comment first. I want to start with a comment from Akbar, who says, don't start with data, start with narrating the problem. He thinks this is really good advice. I agree. I live, breathe data visualization and data storytelling. So I was, you know, you had my full attention here. I really love this topic. I know you mentioned the three C's of a good story, which was clear, care, and a call to action. And I wanted to sort of dig a little bit deeper on that last C, that call to action. Do you have any best practices or tips for, you know, real life applications of how do we actually get this call to action in front of our audience?
Yes. So a lot of times the call to action, for that to resonate, it requires you to understand the business. So business strategy, what is the business trying to solve for? What are the pain points, right? Are you trying to expand as a business? Are you in growth mode? Or are you expanding into new markets? So focusing on the business strategy first could get you to frame your call to action a lot better on what the leader will care about.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Thank you so much for that. It's also a little difficult to make the audience care sometimes. So I'd love to hear your tips on that as well. I know we want our audience to only care about the things we need them to care about, but any tips on that?
Yes. So this, a lot of times I would spend a lot of time upfront in listening to my internal clients on what matters to them. So in those sessions, a lot of times you can find takeaways on what, you know, what makes their eyes lit up, right, in the session. Is it employee retention? Is it, when it comes to employee retention, for example, is it the cost savings or is it about getting the job done? Or is it about innovation and building new products? So once you're able to hone in on what they really care about, take those away and make sure you remember them when you're writing your story later on.
I love it. Great advice. Thank you. And then we had another question here, how to develop the skills required to be good at data storytelling.
So again, the three components, right? Data, you'll want to have strong technical skills to be able to manipulate data and create visualizations as a second step. And that different tools that you can, of course, use for data visualization, lots of free courses online that you can find to get better at the visualization piece. I think the story part is probably the most difficult. It requires you to have business acumen and then a bit of practice. I've always recommended my team to practice in front of a small audience who love and care about you. So someone who is supportive is a champion of data analytics and just run it by them, right? Maybe not the senior leader that you're presenting to at the end, maybe someone on the team who is friendly. And show them what you're going to present beforehand and get their thoughts. If it doesn't resonate with the leader's team, it probably won't resonate with the leader. So that's being a good rule of thumb in my experience.
Yeah, that definitely makes sense. And I think it's important on who you choose as that individual, because it can be somebody who loves you too much, because then they won't give you the critical feedback. They'll just say, amazing, you're great.
Yes.
Go present this. But yeah, great point on having that little practice session before you take it up to the leaders.
Yeah. I would say that it's helpful to find a spectrum of audience for yourself, right? Someone who may not know data analytics very well at all, so you can anticipate questions on the other spectrum. And then also someone who knows data inside and out, who will ask you the tough, difficult questions that are more technical. So you get sort of business questions, technical questions beforehand.
Yeah, yep. So you're ready for just about anything at that point. And then lastly, we had a comment here from Heather, and she says, demonstrating business impact is often forgotten, and that is great advice. So I wanted to ask you, do you have any examples of when this was successful for you, when you actually were able to show the business impact?
Yeah, so definitely as far as cost savings, that goes a long way, right? Or revenue, additional revenue generation. So usually when I take on projects internally, I think about the business impact upfront. We are at a point where there are too many projects to take on, so we have to prioritize. And business impact is something that is really useful in prioritization. How, you know, in creating visualization, maybe you think about your user base, right? But in solving an analytics problem, you think about how many more dollars will this generate for the business, whether that's added revenue, whether that's cost savings, additional profit margins, customer base, and so on. Think about that upfront. So I think if you're able to show that you have identified a problem worth solving that will have clear business impact, then you're simply following up to check on whether or not you have delivered on your promise. I found that to be much easier. So do the hard work upfront.
Yes, very important. Serena, thank you so much for taking the time and chatting with us today and answering all of the questions. Really, really appreciate your time here.
Thank you so much for having me. Have a great rest of your day. Bye, everyone.
Bye.